Hello everyone, Ranjita here. Welcome back to my channel. I know all of you are stuck up at home without much craft supplies, but today I am here with a fun recycling idea where I will be recycling old used up tiny paint bottles into a beautiful fridge magnet that will make up a cute gift as well. Before we move on further, kindly consider subscribing to my channel so that you get more regular updates. So let's get started. Firstly, what I'm doing is I've taken this small tiny paint bottle. I've done using it and now I wanted to clean it. So I'm putting it in a bowl of hot water for a couple of minutes and then I'm cleaning the dried up paint. So here you can see the clean paint bottle. I'm also taking an MDF or wooden base. I had this. If you do not have such a base, you can repurpose or reuse an old cardboard box, but the cardboard has to be thick enough so that it can hold the weight of the glass bottle. Once you are sure with your base, what you are doing is I'm painting it white just so that I can start off with a clean base. Now here I've taken a printed kitchen tissue. You can use any decoupage tissue or any magazine cutout as well to put on your background. So since it had gray stripe, I thought I will be using it as a base for my vase that I will be doing with this paint bottle. I've put my base on the tissue and I'm roughly cutting the tissue into size. I'm slightly cutting it larger than required. Once I'm done sticking the tissue onto the base, I will cut off the excess tissue. So I'm taking Mod Podge here. In case if you do not have Mod Podge, you just mix Fevicol or regular white craft glue with water in the ratio of 1:1 and you are good to go. That is your DIY Mod Podge. So I'm giving an even coat of Mod Podge on my base and I'm carefully placing my tissue onto the base. Make sure you place it very gently without any wrinkles. I'm just making sure the position is right. Like I said, I wanted the gray base for my flower vase. So I'm placing the tissue on it and I'm slowly running my finger, gently rubbing it on the surface so that the tissue adheres well to the base without any air bubbles trapped underneath and so that there are no wrinkles formed. Once that my tissue has stuck well to the base, I'm going ahead and giving it another coat of Mod Podge over the tissue. This seals the tissue properly to the base. I'm giving it an even coat of Mod Podge all over. Make sure you adhere the tissue well on the sides of your base as well. This gives a very good finish. Once I'm done giving a top coat of Mod Podge and the Mod Podge layer is dry, make sure it is very dry, then I'm taking a piece of sandpaper and then just roughly rubbing it on the sides of my MDF base. This will cut off or tear off the excess tissue very neatly. In case if you try to tear it with your hand, there are chances that you might tear up excess tissue, but this sandpaper technique works perfectly well and it gives a very smooth and even finish on your sides. But for this technique, you have to make sure that your top coat of Mod Podge is completely dry and your tissue is well adhered to the base. In case if you try to do it on a wet surface, you have chances of ripping off the entire tissue. So make sure the base is dry. Once I am done, I am just taking a little sponge and then sponging archival ink in the shade of blue on the corners. This step is totally optional. I just wanted to give in some depth to my project, so I'm doing it. You can do this with paint as well, but paint is much thicker and opaque and might ruin your project, so I'm doing it with an ink pad. Once I'm done that, I'm taking archival ink in black and I'm stamping a sentiment onto this. In case if you do not have such clear stamps with you, You can cut out sentiments from magazines or newspapers and then just stick it onto your base as a quotation of your choice. Now I'm going ahead and working on my bottle. This is my DIY chalk paint. In the next coming videos, I will be coming up with how you can make your own chalk paints. As of now, if you do not have chalk paints, just use any regular acrylic multi-surface paint and color the bottle in the color of your choice, matching to your background. I'm using yellow chalk paint and I'm giving an even coat onto the bottle. I'm using a sponge dauber, as you can see. You can might as well do it with a brush, but I chose to do it with sponge because when you dab paint with a sponge, you get a very, very subtle texture on your surface. This makes the project a little more interesting. So I'm dabbing the paint with a sponge all over the bottle. Once my base layer of yellow chalk paint is completely dry, I'm taking a earbud or a Q-tip and dabbing it into white acrylic paint and just making dots all over my surface. I didn't want to add too much detailing onto my bottle, but these tiny dots will definitely bring in more life into my project and will also match up with my background tissue, which also had a white polka dot kind pattern going all over the surface. So I'm taking a Q-tip, dipping it into white acrylic paint, and then making dots all over the surface of my bottle. That's it, my project is almost ready. Here you can see how beautiful the bottle turned out. Nobody will even believe that it was reused paint bottle. Now what I am doing is, the rim looks a little unfinished, so I am just adding some glue onto my rim and I'm wrapping it with white yarn. You can do it with burlap or whatever thread is available at your place. I had white yarn and I thought it'll match up with the colors that I'm using on my project. Just put in some craft glue and then just wrap up the rim with this yarn. You do not have to be very artistic to finish a project, but adding such little details on your project will definitely bring in more interest and will make it look more professional and less handmade. So as you can see, I'm just wrapping up the yarn all around the rim. So this will cover all the unfinished edges of the rim. So here you can see my finished bottle with little polka dots and wrapped up yarn. I had these flowers in my stash. In case if you do not have such flowers, you can quickly make some paper flowers and then wrap it with some wire. And I'm placing it into this bottle, making it look like a little flower vase. Alternatively, you can fill this little bottle with some potting soil and have tiny succulents in it. Or you can make flowers and succulents with clay as well and put it in this bottle, or you can have some fresh flowers as well. Go ahead and use your imagination to make this little piece or little bottle into a beautiful decor. It'll also make a cute gift during this lockdown period when you have no supplies at home. So I'm going ahead. I have varnished my base and bottle well. Now I'm sticking it up with hot glue gun. This finishes my project. All I'm doing is adding some hot glue onto my bottle and firmly adhering it onto my base. You can leave it as it is and gift it to your loved ones, but I chose to convert it into a fridge magnet and have some daily piece of motivation on my fridge. So I am sticking up two magnets behind this, two magnets because I wanted them to hold up the weight of the glass bottle well. That's it, my project is done. You can see the close-up images here. I hope you liked my little attempt of turning this cute little empty paint bottle into a beautiful piece of decor. I know we are all in a lockdown period and we do not have too many craft supplies to craft. But look around your house, maybe you can find such tiny treasures with which you can make cute gifts or home decor items. So go ahead and recycle the little stuff that you have lying around your house. Thank you so much for stopping by. I hope I inspired you. Also, do consider subscribing to my channel and tap on the bell icon so that you get notified every time I post a video. Also, do follow me on my social media where I share my craft, card making and other videos and photos with you. The links are given in the description box below. Thank you.